Welcome back to Amazing Mind. If you have just joined us, we have as our next guest, author Robert Steelman. Now, Robert Steelman is an honors grad of HMI College of Hypnotherapy. He is also the editor of the Southern Nevada Healthcare Journal. The reason I'm having him on my show today is he is the author of one of my favorite books. It's called Beyond a Lifetime. And we're very lucky because this show, Amazing Mind, is his very first stop on his book tour. Please help me welcome my guest.
Thanks for having me.
Bob, tell me about your book.
Well, it's kind of a dead man's journey. And the man, Michael Jacobs, the main character in the book, finds out after he's died that he still has consciousness. It's just he's just been elevated to a different plane. And unfortunately for Michael, when he lived his life, he was kind of clueless and kind of lived with blinders on. And he continues that into death until he encounters his ex-wife, who had recently died, and realizes that he still loves her. And when she suddenly vanishes, he goes on a quest to find her. And in order to do that, he has to find himself before he can find her. So he goes through a series of adventures and is basically able to see how his life could have been different if he made different choices.
You know, that was my favorite part of the book, and can I tell you the truth? This book actually changed my life because as I watched Michael's adventures with seeing what would have happened if he made better choices, I became much more mindful and conscious of the way that I talk to people, especially the people that I love most. Was that your intent when you wrote about that part of the book?
Well, it's really nice to hear. I'm honored to hear that. No, my intent was to write a book. I just wanted to write a good story, a page-turner. But I found as I was writing about Michael and his journey, as the story unfolded, it was really touching me in really deep ways. And it really did kind of become a blueprint for me. And it still continues to be kind of a guide for me in my life.
You know, very few men, just to tell you the truth, can write good women characters. But I felt you were actually inside of the main character, her name was Margie, inside of her head, because you wrote from the perspective of a woman. She's got to be based on a real person, is she?
That's funny you should ask. Michael was based in large part on me, and some of the other characters were based on people in my life. But when I was writing Margie, I felt like I was spinning something from whole cloth. I really had no one in my life that was like that. And I was kind of sad because as I was writing her, I was actually finding her kind of appealing. And
well, you not only liked her, you loved her.
And 4 years ago, I actually met the love of my life. And it wasn't long before I realized that I had written her long before I met her.
So, wow, that's, you kind of manifested her, huh?
Yeah.
Now,
My own mental bank.
You did a little mental bank in finding the love of your life. Why this book? Why a book about death?
I've always been fascinated by death. It's something that we all walk towards, and it's a common bond we have, and yet we don't talk about it very much, and I wanted to talk about it. I wanted to think about it, and it intrigued me, and yet it stayed inside my head. So when I finally decided to make good on a pledge to myself that I was going to write a novel, it seemed like a really good place to start.
But you started writing this book 20 years ago, and you finished it, you said, 7 years ago.
Yeah.
But I just got my copy. This thing was only published last month.
That's right.
Why?
Well, as hypnotherapists, we know that we can have limiting beliefs and things that kind of stop us from reaching our full potential, and that was certainly the case for me. It was such a personal book that I think I wasn't ready to live it out loud, so to speak. And last 5 years, I've gone through a lot of changes in my life, and in particular, a year and a half ago, I decided to make a career change, and I came here to HMI. And I certainly got a wonderful career out of it. I find it very personally satisfying, but I got so much more. Through the things I was learning and the classes and the teachers and mentoring and working with my own clients, I came into my own. I became comfortable in my own skin. And I also found in working with clients that I was using a lot of the themes that I had in the book with them. And so it just seemed like the right time.
So you're using some of the themes in your book in your hypnotherapy practice.
Yeah.
Can you tell us about that?
Sure. Well, I feel like, you know, we all have our stories, and we have our stories that we present to the outside world, and of course we have our stories that we have inside of us, our internal stories. And again, as hypnotherapists, I think we know that sometimes those stories don't exactly serve us. And so what I really like to be able to do is help somebody go and look at those stories and look at those choices and hopefully do a little bit of editing and get it to a place where those stories fit them in their life today.
Well, you sound like a real writer. Can you teach us a technique?
Sure. One of the things that I've done, and usually in third or fourth session, is I will take a client into state, and if there's something that came up in the cognitive where they had something that was traumatic in their life or something that was significant that they seemed to still be stuck within, I'll have them go back to that time and actually have a conversation with that former self. And hopefully through that, be able to work on what shame or guilt there might be associated with it and write a new story that they can, you know, carry with them.
And when that client awakens in your chair after having a conversation with a younger self, what happens?
They find it really interesting, and they usually come out with a smile, and it's empowering because it's a way to integrate more fully with yourself.
Well, you know, I found this a very metaphysical book. It dealt with topics of life and death. My first question is, do you believe the afterlife looks anything like the novel that you wrote?
Well, if you're asking if I'm privy to what the afterlife is like, I'm not. I'm more than content to wait and to find out. But
here. Beats the alternative.
But I really did want to have something that made sense to me. And I have to say that I'm quite comfortable with the picture I painted.
You know, as hypnotherapists, maybe more than other mental health professionals, we deal with issues of life and death and metaphysics. How do you use this book when people come into your practice with these really heavy, profound issues or challenges or the angst about life and death?
Well, I think one of the things, going back to former aspects of yourself, is really helpful. And I find that even with people, you know, with weight loss and or smoking cessation, there usually is, you know, a deeper meaning, and it can have, you know, some metaphysical or, you know, something deeper. And so using this, and what I've actually been developing now is a workbook as a companion that I can give to a client, and I can have them kind of follow along on Michael's journey, Michael and Margie's journey, and help them kind of uncover their own journey, and then in session be able to work on some of those things that they've uncovered.
What kind of questions do you ask in your workbook that follows these two people's journey?
Well,
you brought notes.
I brought some questions, yeah. So here's just a couple. For example, Michael relives part of his life and even his encounters with the person that he was at that time. And so I ask people to think about a memory from your life and what you might say to your former self.
What else?
And there's a character who believes that she knows what's best and tries to impose her will over a loved one. So I ask people to think about a past or present situation where you might have done the same and how it has impacted you and that relationship.
Now, do people have to come in and use the workbook with you in hypnotherapy? Or is this something, when someone buys the book and they get the companion workbook, someone can work through his or herself?
I'm structuring it so it's something that someone can work with by themselves, because I really do think that it just seems natural. But as I've seen it work in my practice, I just think it could be something that it can be geared towards somebody. And I actually hope that hypnotherapists might find it of interest too, and maybe give them some ways of exploring things in their own practice.
So that would be a nice tool for hypnotherapists to be able to use.
I like to think so.
Well, especially as we deal with these really profound issues. Is there another technique that you use for people to examine the choices in their life?
One of the most important things, I think, is to allow these people to kind of have an outside view, to be able to look at those choices, those decisions, and be able to see if there are ways or how they can do them in a more positive way, a more empowering way. But I think overall, the biggest thing that I'm trying to get across is to allow my clients to better embrace their life.
I like it. And I'm really excited that you chose this show to be the first step on your book tour. What else do you have planned?
Well, I'm developing a schedule now, and I'll have it on my website.
Well, I know everyone's going to want to see this and learn more about Margie and Michael's journey and about the unique ways that you use this in your hypnotherapy practice. And everybody can reach Robert Steelman on hmigrads.com. But in addition, you can get the book, Beyond a Lifetime, on Amazon.com. As a matter of fact, those of you in the 21st century, you can also download it right onto your Kindle. Well, it appears that we're out of time for today. But I want to thank Bob Steelman for coming on and talking to us about his brand new book and his very unique hypnotherapy practice. And I want to thank you at home for watching the show. I hope you will join us next time when we meet more people and continue to explore the amazing mind. Please stay tuned. We have a lot more coming up for you on HMI Web TV, that's Hypnotherapy Television, 24/7. Thank you.